Could COVID-19 vaccines increase risk of HIV infection? In this pandemic, the world needs at least one functional vaccine against COVID-19. While some candidates are leading the race, none of them obtained full approval from the FDA. Recently, a group of researchers published a paper in The Lancet about COVID-19 vaccine candidates. They highlighted in the paper that such vaccines might increase the risk of HIV. The idea is recognized in the history of adenovirus-based vaccines. For reasons yet to be certain, people who receive adenovirus-based vaccines have a higher chance to contract HIV infection. Lawrence Carre, the paper's co-author, said, "If I were in a sub-Saharan African country and making a decision as to what I would want from my country for a general population use of a SARS-CoV-2 vaccine, I don't see why I would pick an AD5 vector vaccine when there are many other alternative choices." The same researchers learned the issue back in 2007. An experimental HIV vaccine used in some people raised their risk of HIV. That vaccine contained adenovirus type 5 to elicit immune responses. However, the immunization endangered some of the participants who joined the STEP trials. Investigators confirmed a greater risk of HIV acquisition among vaccinated individuals. The danger seems to be greater in men with AD5 seropositive results than uncircumcised men. Today, 4 COVID-19 vaccine candidates utilize AD5. The vaccine design converted the adenovirus into a vector to deliver a non-infectious part of SARS-CoV-2. This allows safe exposure to elicit an immune response. These candidates are in late-stage clinical trials in different parts of the globe. Meanwhile, other players in the COVID-19 vaccine race applied different adenovirus strains. Researchers said that the ones from Johnson & Johnson and AstraZeneca and the University of Oxford are unlike the AD5. There is no evidence yet that those adenoviruses can increase the risk of HIV infection, according to Science magazine. Immunity Bio, a new player in the race, received approval from the US FDA for its first human clinical trials of an experimental vaccine. The Phase 1 trials will commence in the US. But CEO Patrick Soon-Shiong hopes that it can be tested in South Africa. He noted the STEP findings and stressed that their AD5 COVID-19 vaccine has 4 deleted genes. The deletion lowers immune responses related to those genes. On top of that, the company's vaccine contains 2 distinct genes of the coronavirus to elicit better immune responses, which translates to greater protection.